Good morning, everybody. Hopefully, you had a good weekend, and we have a little bit shorter than normal call, but I think some important stuff. First, as a reminder, we will be closed next Monday. I'm assuming not many of you will be working either, so we'll skip that coaching call, and hopefully, you have a good Memorial Day weekend. So, the first, I want to talk about your website and use the 5 second rule. So, is your website 2022 ready? So, here's the 5 second rule. So in the first 5 seconds, if somebody goes to your website in the first 5 seconds, it doesn't grab them, they're gone. So what you should do is go to your website. Go to your website and then without clicking or scrolling, take everything in. What do they see there on that first page above the fold, above, on the page? Without scrolling, what do they see? Okay, then see how many of the following questions you can answer. So, who benefits from your service? Who benefits from your service? What particular person? If it sounds like it's open to everybody, you're going to help everybody, is that a good thing or a bad thing? It sounds like it's going to work for everybody. Hey, we're investment experts. We can help you with all your. Everybody's got that right. It's a bad thing. You want to talk to the person you're after. You want to tell them exactly who you work with and why you are the person to work with for their particular needs. Does it tell you what makes you different from others? Guys, how many people say that they've got all sorts of credentials? How many people say that? All of them. How many people say, hey, you know what? We put your needs first. How many people say that? How many people say, we're a safe money experts? How many people say that we're investment experts? How many people say, I mean, guys, if your website, if anything in your website, any other advisor can say that, guess what's happening to your website? Strengthened or weak? If any other advisor could say, yeah, I do that. Yeah, I do that. Yeah, you get lost in the crowd, Nick. Exactly. Weak, Tom. And then you got to tell them what their next step is. If you don't tell them to call, if you just tell your teenage kid, hey, your room's dirty, what's going to happen? You got to do what? Tell them what to do. If you tell somebody, well, let's talk about our power of attorney and Social Security. When we tell them, hey, it doesn't work with Social Security, what do they do? Oh yeah. I guess that's a problem. That's something I should get fixed sometime. When we go through the story, what happens? When you go through the story, what happens to that? Does it strengthen or weaken their call to action? They want it fixed now. That's right. They want it fixed now. So go to your website and answer these questions. Who benefits from your service? And ask your wife, ask your spouse, ask your friend, ask your mom, ask your dad. Ask them these three questions. Ask them these three questions. Okay, look, here's my website. Who do you think benefits from our service? What makes us different from any other advisor out there? Do you know what your next step should be when you see this? Ask them these things. So what is a call to action? A call to action is a marketing reference to a piece of content, such as an image, button, or text intended to prompt user to perform a specific action. So what kind of action could they take? So give me some ideas of actions they could take. What are some actions you could ask them to take? Well, they could call you, that's one. Ask for a report, excellent. And when so contact me, so be more specific. Because call or text or email, you want to have one of those or all three of those. The more ways you can make it easy for them to contact you. So John says here, create a consultation for Social Security. Yeah. So I mean, give them a reason to call you. Now, let's talk about Social Security. If all you say is you're a Social Security expert, are there other people out there saying that? Yeah, so what do you want to do with Social Security? Social Security is good, but you want to do what? What would be something you could put on your front page about Social Security? Yes, the unique selling proposition, John, which is, are you using the program that will replace your spouse's Social Security when they get called to the pearly gates? Now, how many of your competitors have that on the front page of their website? How many of your competitors have that on the front page of their workshop? Is that giving people a reason to call you now? How many people would like that program? How many of the people would like to replace their spouse's Social Security income? Yeah, everyone would. Exactly right. Now, after you've done this, after you've gone to your website, had your wife, parents, friends, whoever, colleagues, look at the website and answer these questions, then what do you think you want to do? You want to look at it on your computer, on a tablet, on a laptop, on a cell phone. Why? Why do you want to look at it on all those things? Is everybody going to go to you from the website? Is everybody going to go to you from a tablet? Yeah, it's a format change. You want to make sure their website fits for all of these things. Okay, because it's going to look different on all of these things. You make sure it works on all of these things. Then the other thing you want to do is make sure it's first-time visitor-friendly. So if it's the first time somebody gets there, is it easy to navigate? Guys, if you've been to a site that's hard to navigate, how long do you spend on that site? A long time, or you're out of there? Yeah, you're gone. How do you showcase your expertise? With a blog, a newsletter, videos? How do you let them know? Because if you just say you're an expert, is that going to work? How many of your competitors say they're an expert? In today's world, can you say anything, or do you have to prove it? You have to prove it. But up front. Not see me, come to my office, and then I'll prove it to you. You need to prove it to them up front. Why do we do all the non-financial things, guys? Why do we do all the non-financial things in a 20-point checklist? To prove that we care. Because do they believe that we care? Everybody says they care. Everybody says they're going to put their concerns ahead of them. The reason we do the non-financial things for the 21-point checklist is prove that we care, prove that we're going to put their interests above our own time, money, etc. You got to do that on your website with your expertise. You got to prove to them, you got to give them information that's going to make their lives better. Does that make sense? Give value before or give value after they become a client? Give value before or after they become a client? Before. That's right, Mark. Are your services clearly defined? Do they even know what you do? Now, do you want to talk about a gazillion things you do or one thing you do? One. Very good. Very good, guys. And then how can your business contact? We just talked about this. So I want to show you a great example. Now, this is not one of our advisors, and they don't even work in areas that we work in, but let's talk about some of these things. So remember, we want to know what? Three questions. Jeff, can you help me remember these three questions? Who benefits from your service? What makes you different from others? And what's your visitor's next step? So let's go to this example of a website. So what was the first one, Jeff? Sorry about that.
The first one was, let me look.
Who benefits from your service?
Thank you, Missy.
Yep.
Yeah, Missy is my computer brain, not Jeff. Sorry about that, Jeff. So who benefits from your service? So if we look at this, financial guidance for professionals who receive equity-based compensation specializing in incentive stock options, restricted units, and non-qualified stock options. Is that very clear about who's going to benefit? How clear is this about who's going to benefit from calling this entity? It's precise. That's right, Nick. Precise. Okay. What makes you different from others? Well, I guess the fact that they're very precise, because how many of their competitors are saying we specialize in incentive stock options, restricted units, non-qualified stock options? Is it very clear they're different from everybody else? I think it is. And then the last one is call to action. Did they give away to or is there something on here for people to get in contact with them? Yes. Contact, schedule a call. So on here, why are we doing this? Okay. Oh, shoot. I guess we can stay here for a second. So what do we do, where we are, and see they have blog. The other thing that many entities are saying now is you should address your fees. Should you hide your fees or address your fees up front? Up front. Yep, John, up front. Makes sense. So this is an example of what you want it to look like. You know, tell us what brings you joy. I think that that's to me is worthless. But everything else, they hit it right on target. So does your website look like this? Is it very specific about who you're working with, why you're different from all your competitors, and making it very easy to call and get in touch with you? Now, one thing I would add here is, does everybody want to schedule a call immediately? There is a blog, but are they giving the people an option to sign up for their blog right up front? No, they should somehow get people to connect. Not everybody's ready to call, so you need to capture them somehow. Are they making any offer of value here? I mean, they say that they're specializing in these things. Have they given people who have these things any additional information, anything of value? Free report, little video about why it's important to manage these things, anything? No. So they are missing that. So this is the assumption that as soon as I see, oh, you're specializing in this, I'm going to call you. No, you got to what? Prove that by calling you, and because you're specialized in this, you're going to give me things nobody else can give me. And I'd rather not call you for that. I'd rather know up front before I call you. Does that make sense? So please, please, please grab your website, ask your friends, neighbors, and relatives these three questions, and look at it on all different platforms. And why is it so essential to have a website that works well nowadays? Why is it essential to have a website that works well? Where's the first place people are going to go to check you out? People used to drive in the 90s. People would drive by my house. They figure out where I lived and drive by my house to see, do I live in a good house or a crappy house? Do I have a well-kept lawn or a bad? Then they would drive by my office. But where do they go now? They go to the website. That's your brick and mortar. So how much money, time, and effort should you invest in your website? Now, unfortunately, I've seen a lot of guys invest a lot of time, effort, and money in their website, and the website looks beautiful, but guess what? Are the people that you hire to manage your website, are they worrying about these three things? Who benefits from your service, what makes you different, and what your visitors accept? Is this where people who design a website spend all their time, making sure that it works or making sure that it's beautiful? Where do they want? Because they want to put your website on examples, and all they want is what? Pretty, pretty, pretty. And does beautiful sell anything? They can get beautiful anywhere they want. They'll look on the web. They want to know, who are you work with? Why will you help me? How do I contact you? Does that make sense? So please, we're coming into summer here. Now is a great time to be investing in these kinds of things, to make sure you have a website that actually is effective in capturing leads and getting people to move forward. Make sense? So the next thing I'm going to talk about is, guys, I am not an expert on this. I am not an expert on this, but it's something, and we do have experts on the call, so I hope you'll forgive me and certainly call me out if any of these things are wrong, but luckily I'm using other experts to make these points for me. But this is something you should know about. So this is an article out of Advisor's Perspectives. Thanks, Mark, for sending this, getting my attention. Why Joe Namath may be the biggest threat to your client's retirement. I learned all sorts of things from this article. You should all read this article. And my wife was actually talking to me today about, about the fact that, hey, these medical advantage plans are awesome because they have silver sneakers. And silver sneakers gets you a gym membership. And I said, wait. Just so you know, those Medicare advantages aren't what they are all what they're advertising themselves as. And I didn't know that. I thought, hey, medical or Medicare Advantage sounds good. And hey, get a free gym membership. That sounds good. I mean, all those things, that sounds good. And then when I read this article, I was like, holy crap, I did not know these things. And now the reason she was telling me about that is because she had three of her friends talk about how great it was that their Medicare Advantage did these things. It gave them a free gym membership. So that's, and when it comes to these kind of things, does Joe Namath sell or who sells people? Joe Namath or who really sells people? Maybe agents. What I just gave you an example of here. Who sells people? Ah, Tom's got it. Friends. Didn't I just say my wife said, hey, this is awesome because my friends get silver sneakers with this. That's who sells. So if all your friends are getting Medicare Advantage, guess what you think? I should what? Get it. Sounds good to me. They're not stupid. They're doing pretty well. Why not just follow the leader? So you got to educate your clients on this or they'll do what? They'll just follow the leader. And I'm not saying Medicare Advantage is bad. I'm just saying as we walk through this, there's some things in there that I didn't know till I read the article. My wife didn't know at all because she didn't read the article. It just is very, very important. And it's being sold on TV by big names, right? So how ignoring healthcare costs in retirement can turn into financial trouble. The seniors, these ads target often already have a very good Medicare insurance. They may be enrolled in Parts A and B with a Medigap policy, also known as a Medicare supplement, and a Part D drug plan. With this type of coverage, seniors can, again, guys, I'm 61, and I still don't know all these things. I'm very vague. And even people that have Medicare, those of you who sell Medicare insurance, whether it's supplemental, Advantage, whatever, how fluent are clients about Medicare? Or is it all this gray, fuzzy stuff that they don't really get? Everybody's saying it's poor or zero, right? So with this type of coverage, seniors can count on highly predictable healthcare costs. They pay a monthly premium for Medicare policy and a Part D plan, but have few, if any, additional out-of-pocket costs for healthcare. They know what they're getting. They know exactly what they're getting with regular Medicare, a Medicare supplement, and a Part D. They know what they're getting. In addition, this type of coverage does not have networks. If you have Medicare with Medicare Sup, you can go anywhere you want that takes Medicare, and you'll get the service. And contrary to popular belief, 99% of providers accept Medicare. Now, what Medicare Advantage want to have you believe? That they don't. The medical providers are the ones who make the healthcare decisions, not the insurance company. If the doctor says the senior needs a service, they get it. No prior authorization from insurance company is required. That's for Medicare, Medicare Sup, and Part D. But here's how Medicare Advantage plans, touted by Joe Namath and all the other commercials out there, can damage a senior's financial health. With Medicare Advantage, the predictable costs are gone, replaced by unpredictable hodgepodge of co-pays and deductibles. So Medicare is already complicated. What happens when they get a Medicare Advantage and all of a sudden they get all sort of a hodgepodge of co-pays and deductible? What happens to that complexity of Medicare? Yeah, it becomes even more complicated. Now, whenever a senior uses healthcare services, they'll pay maybe a 20-year, 45-year, 320 for a hospitalization up to 6 days. Plus, the senior's Medicare Advantage plans must be conscious of provider networks. Prior authorization requirements are also commonplace with Medicare Advantage. Prior authorization requirements means you got to get their permission before you get something done. In fact, 99% of Medicare Advantage plans include prior authorization. Guys, how many seniors do you think get burned daily because they go get a service thinking, I'm with Medicare, they're obviously going to cover it, and then they get a bill in a month? Yeah, a ton of people. If a senior doesn't get prior authorization but utilize the healthcare service anyways, they may be required to pay 100% of the cost, regardless of any out-of-pocket spending limits. Spending limits only apply when plan members follow the rules of Medicare Advantage insurance companies. And how complicated are the rules, do you think? We've already said, way complicated. Going out of network when not allowed or not getting prior authorization means the senior will pay everything for themselves. You guys, how many of our senior clients are traveling? How many of our senior clients travel? What's the likelihood they're going to be in network? Even if they knew what their network was, what's the likelihood they're going to be in network? And with urgent care, can you always go to your provider for urgent care? All these little unexpected health care expenses can add up to one giant catastrophic hit to a senior's retirement savings. And there's no instant replays. There's one more thing that Joan Abe doesn't mention, which is when seniors switch to coverage of Medicare Advantage, they may never be able to switch back to coverage they had before. Some will try Medicare Advantage for the first time, may qualify for a 12-month period, but not everyone does. If they don't, or if they wait 12 months and one day to switch back, they may not be allowed to get back to Medigap insurance policy without going through medical underwriting. Is that a problem for seniors, having to go through medical underwriting? Yes. Which gives the insurance companies the opportunity to deny Medigap coverage when they used to take it for granted. Having the Medicare talk with clients. All Medicare Advantage plans, a celebrity spokesman, are not bad. The plans may be right for a limited group of seniors, say those who don't mind the risk of unpredictable costs. How many of your clients don't mind the risk of unpredictable healthcare costs? Not many, if any. The point is that Medicare options are often confusing and the consequences of just one little mistake can be devastating. So is this an opportunity? Is this an opportunity? How many people know what we just walked through there? I mean, it took me 5 minutes to go through that. How many of your clients know that? None. Do we have opportunities to do that? Well, first of all, if you want to be a Medicare expert, we have on our resources. So if you go to contacts resources, Medicare and I-65.com, that's a great resource to talk about Medicare insurance. If they've got marketing material, they've got educational material, they've got seminars you can use for either small group, your clients or whatever. So that's, if you want to be an expert, you can certainly do it. And do we have low cost marketing? We talked about this earlier with Social Security. Could you use this with many of our low cost marketing? So let me get in here. Marketing. Low cost. Could you use it with the one question survey to your clients? Could you use it with your clients? Yes. If you go to One Care System or One Question, just give them one question survey lesson, which survey question. So Bonnie says, Medicare Advantage have a maximum out-of-pocket cost. What is the maximum, Bonnie, that they would have out-of-pocket? Or does that depend on a company? Because I don't know. So could you put a question? Yeah, see, it depends on the company. So, and how many people would actually know that, do you think, if you ask them straight up? Obviously, you would. I mean, your clients would, Bonnie, because you're a good advisor. But the average advisor out there, they wouldn't know that. So this is, we can use these things to market. So you could use the one survey system. Could you use the assisted care living facilities? Yes, you could use it for that. Could you use it for retirement if you have the like AT&T Union Retirement or any company specialty that you're helping the retirees? Could you use that? Yes. Could you use it for Be a Star system? Could you do YouTube videos on this? Yes. Could you bumper or business owners probably doesn't or it wouldn't matter because that's an IUL system. Could you use it for a bumper system? Yes. Could you use it for client advisory board? Absolutely. Could you mention it at client appreciation? Yes. Could you do it for a community education system? Could you do it in, we've all seen that where the adult communities have adult education, right? Now, they won't let you sell stuff, but would they allow you to do a seminar on Medicare and how it works? Would they allow that? Yes. Will libraries allow that? Yes. So you could do that. CPA system. Are CPAs experts on Medicare? Are CPAs experts on Medicare, guys? No. Could you work? Yes, so you could use it for that system. Not necessarily for Digital One Directory system. Ebook system, no. Well, yeah, you could use the ebook system. If you go to ebook system, we do have what? Make Medicare Easy package. We could tie it to that. Could you use it with events? Yes. You'd use the, actually, we don't have it in here, but you'd use the I-65 seminar. Could you use it with the financial scorecard? Yes. Could you use a financial, the mini book system really wouldn't apply. Friends helping friends, yes. Ghost, it doesn't apply. Golden referral, yes. Guinness, yes. Halo, yes. Hand referral system, yes. Not with the IBAN letter. Lifetime protection, no. Well, you actually could use a lifetime protection strategy. You could use it with that. Lifetime distribution, no. Monte Carlo, no. Neighborhood mailing, yes. No cost option to leverage your client circle, yes. On-demand webinar, yes. The two tax ones don't really apply. Property cash, yes. Protect your, yes. So guys, how many different systems, no cost or low cost systems, do we have that you could actually use Medicare Advantage or being an expert on Medicare? Now, I get it. I do not want to be an expert on Medicare. So guess what I would do? I don't want to be an expert on Medicare, so what would I do? I may do I-65 because it doesn't really require you to be an expert on I-65. They're giving you all the knowledge right there. But what else could I do, guys? Some of the biggest producers we have on our system are Medicare sub salespeople. Why? Guess what they do during sign-up? They accumulate all sorts of clients. What do you think they do the rest of the year? They sell them. They go back and become their financial advisor using our 21 Lite system and then converting them to the full 21-point checklist clients. So here's the great thing about that. Are they paying for marketing or are they getting paid to market? Are they paying? That's right, Bonnie, cross-selling. Are they getting paid? Is it costing them $5,000 to do a seminar? Are they making maybe $30,000, $40,000 to find all these people? So are they getting paid to market or are they getting? So here's the thing. You don't have to do that. I wouldn't say it's a bad idea, but you don't have to do it. Somebody already said it. You could partner with somebody. Gosh darn it. Let's go down. Okay. So what? So as a reminder, we actually talked. But before we do that, so you can actually partner with a Medicare SUP specialist. Are all Medicare salespeople expert financial advisors? Are most Medicare salespeople expert financial advisors? Would they like to make money the rest of the year? Because do they make money all through the year or is it mostly lumped into, and would they like to make money where they have to do very little work? So would it be, if you don't want to become a Medicare specialist yourself, how aggressively should you market yourself and your services to Medicare specialists? Aggressively. You should be out there courting them, becoming their friends, and partnering with them. Look at all these different, but before we jump too far from this, I showed you all sorts of ways you could use this for Medicare. Remember, just a reminder, 3 weeks ago on 5/2/22, I showed you how you could do it with Social Security. How many of you then went and decided to use one of those low or no cost marketing 3 weeks ago? Many of you thought it was a good idea 3 weeks ago, but what did you do? Did you go and say, okay, I'm going to use that one and that one? So you don't have to say no's, just give me the yeses. How many of you say yes? I did then. You think I could do that? Grab that thing about Social Security. I started to utilize one of the no or low cost. I'm not seeing a single yes. So guys, if you're not doing a seminar, if you're not doing leads, that means you are or are not marketing. How do you get new people in your office? By magic or by marketing? So if you're doing seminars, and our top guys, that's what they do, because that's how you get in front of the most people, hallelujah. If you're running leads, super. Could you utilize these things with your leads as well? Absolutely. But if you're not doing either, how are you getting new people into your office? Do we have ways, no cost ways to get people in office? Please, I'm begging you. I am begging you on my hands and knees. Don't just listen to this stuff. Do the stuff. Grab it. Am I telling you which one of these low-cost methodologies to use? No. Choose whatever one you want. But an idea, now, do you think, are you going to love every one of these ideas, guys? No. But do you think that if there's at least one idea in these, of all the ones, you know, what are we talking about, 15 or 16, is there one in there that you could use? Again, nobody has to say yes to this, but I want somebody to say no. Is there one in there, out of the 16 or so in here that you could, that I've shown you could use, is there one in here you could use? I'm not getting any no's. That means that please, please, please grab one of these. These ideas are worth nothing unless I keep doing that, clicking that, are nothing unless you actually implement them, okay? And but if you have too many things to do, you don't want to be an expert on Medicare or the network, which is what we just talked about. But even if you network, you're going to have to do the marketing or help that Medicare insurance person, because how good are they at marketing? Generally, they're buying what? Leads. How good are they at doing seminars or focus groups for their clients? Good or not good? How many of you would be okay with getting in front of 8 or 10 people if you didn't have to pay for it? I want you all to answer this. How many of you would be willing to get in front of 8 or 10 people if you didn't have to pay for it? Got one yes, two yes. Come on. How many people say, well, guess how you can do that? Network with a Medicare sub person and get them to take their top clients and give them value. Show them the value you're presenting to their clients. So, need another idea for using the no or low cost? What's happening to the divorce rate of people age 50 and up compared to the rest of the divorce rate? Going up and up and up. And when people get a divorce, a gray divorce, a divorce after age 50, what happens? Well, 23% of a man's income drops after divorce. 25% of all divorcees in 2010 were 50 age and over. 41% is how much a woman's income drops. $50 billion is how much the divorce industry earned in 2010. That's 2010. Is that higher or lower? If the divorce rates are going up, is that higher or lower today? So the reality of a gray divorce is it's going to hurt their retirement, it's going to affect their Social Security, most, and it's going to hurt it, going to hurt their income. They may have to get it with the spouse report, division of assets, estate planning, competency, long-term, adult children insurance. Are they ready for this? They are not. So if you are looking for, you don't want to do Medicare, you don't want to do Social Security, well, here's another idea. Become an expert then on gray divorce. And here's the great thing about Social Security, Medicare, or gray divorce. How much do your clients know about these things? A lot or a little? A little. So if you know even some, you are what? If you know even something about Social Security or something about Medicare or something about gray divorce, you become a what? An expert. That's right. An expert. So here's another idea. Could you, if you just read this article, you are going to become an expert. And this article would only take you 15 minutes to read. Read it 3 times. It takes you 45 minutes. You are now an expert on gray divorce. Find, and do you think that a divorce attorney would be willing to partner with you? That you would say, hey, I'd like to send you people. I'd like to send you people. What, how many divorce attorneys are going to say, yep, raise their hands? Oh, yeah, sure, you can do that. Of course they would. So now you're an expert. So could you use these, again, these things, these no cost or low cost marketing for gray divorce? Yes. So please, 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 guys, if you're not spending money on a seminar or workshops, okay, I get it. I get it. Not running leads, I get it. If you are running leads, could you use these ideas? If you're running leads, could you use ideas? Yes or no? Because when you're running leads, you want to sound different than all your competitors. You want to give them a reason to call you. Did we give you give them a reason to call you for Social Security? Yes. Did we give them a reason to call you for Medicare? Yes. After you read this article on divorce, did you give them a reason to call you? Yes. And if you're not doing leads, you're not doing any type of marketing for seminars or workshops, then please, please, please use one of these no cost or low cost ways, whichever one you want, and start getting active. Because we've talked about this many times. There is, what is the one characteristic that makes you lucky? What's the one characteristic that science has shown that makes you more lucky? Nick's got it. Come on, everybody answer this. Not hard work? Nope, nope, nope. Guys, how many people work their asses off, have three jobs, and they're still poor? It's not hard work. How many people who have a sunshine attitude, because I hear think positive. How many people have a positive attitude and are still poor? What's the one thing that makes you lucky? Bonnie's got it, getting in front of a lot of people. The more contacts you have, the more people you know, the luckier you get. So is all these low-cost ways of marketing are just ways of what? Getting in front of more people at no or low cost. So I'm hammering here because you're on 5Q because you want to make more money. I get it when you say, Mike, I can't afford or don't want to spend, or, you know, I've been burned on workshops before. I get it. So why spend $5,000-$7,000? I mean, again, our biggest producers do use those, but maybe you don't want to do that. That's cool. But then if you don't want to do that, we have tons of low cost or no cost ways. Please, this is the ways of getting in front of more people at no or low cost. Find the one you like and just hammer it. Become the best person ever at that particular no or low cost methodology. Make sense? Super. So please forgive me for bashing you about the head and shoulders with this, but this is how you're going to get in front of more people at no or low cost. These low cost things. Have an idea nobody else is talking about, and use one of these systems to get in front of more people at no or low cost. Even people that are doing workshop seminars, hey, could they benefit from this? Absolutely. Even people running leads, can they benefit from this? Absolutely. Make sense? Super. Well, I really appreciate you guys. Please forgive me for bashing about the head and shoulders with this, but good ideas without action are not going to give you any benefit. So you guys have a wonderful week, a safe and happy Memorial Day weekend, because we'll talk to you next, and we'll talk to you here in a couple of weeks. Thanks, everybody.